Good morning, dear friends. I'm Sol from Biological Sciences with Sol channel. Today I'm with a new video. In this video, I'm going to discuss about introduction to evolution. Mainly, different theories of origin of life are going to be discussed in this video. So don't forget to like, share, comment this video. And those of you not yet subscribed, please subscribe my channel and let us proceed. Introduction to evolution. Evolution is the gradual change of organisms on Earth over a long period of time, with the new forms of life replacing the old ones. Later, I'll show you different theories about origin of life. However, once life is originated or formed, there is a change which carried out on these organisms to replace the old ones by new forms of life. As evolution has progressed, new species are arriving. The biodiversity of the planet increases. That means the number of plants, the number of animals, the number of microorganisms from time to time increase. Larger and more complex organisms replacing the smaller and simpler ones. And even some species have been extinct. Evolution can be the changes in genetic composition of population. Not only change or replace the old one by new life, but in evolution, there is a change in genetic composition of a population. This is maybe because of the meiosis, which is type of cell division, hybridization, natural selection, or due to mutation. So this results in the formation of even new species from already existing population. Change in genetic composition of a population leads to a sequence of events by which the population diverge from other population of the same species and may lead to origin of new species. As you know, population is group of organisms or group of individuals of the same species with the same characteristics. For example, if this is a population which contains the same organisms of the same character, group of organisms of the same character, due to the change in genetic composition of this population, a new species may be formed. That means new population may be diverge from the existing population to make new species. So change in genetic composition of the existing population may lead to formation of a new species. So this change in genetic composition of a population leads to origin of new species. The theories of evolution describe how the various forms of life on Earth emerge and developed. There are two main points in theories of evolution. One is how life is emerged, how life is originated, and how this life is developed. Once the life is formed, it must be developed. Therefore, in the theories of evolution, the two things are mainly described. The emerging or the formation of organism is described, as well as the development of these organisms is discussed in the theories of evolution. The next point is about theories of origin of life on Earth. So there are five main theories of origin of life. The first one is special creationism theories of origin of life. The second is spontaneous generation theories of origin of life. The third one is eternity of life theories of origin of life, and cosmozoan theories of origin of life, and biochemical origin of theories of life. So these are the five main theories of origin of life on Earth. So in the next slides, each of these theories of origin of life is going to be discussed in detail. Special creationism. This special creationism, theories of origin of life, states that different forms of life on earth were created by a supreme being or by God, and it is always linked with religion and mainly focus on the spiritual matters. So as a believer, we may accept these theories of origin of life. However, this type of origin of life has four types, and four types of creationism theories are introduced nowadays. Gap creation. This gap creation is a type of special creationism theories of origin of life. That means this theory discusses about large gaps between the formation of Earth and the creation of all the plants and animals. Of course, Earth and animals and plants were made by God, but there was a gap between the formation of Earth and the formation of or the creation of animals and plants according to this theory. And the gap could be billions or millions of years. The other type of special creationism theory is old Earth or progressive creation. This type of theory accepts the Big Bangs as the origin of the universe. And the Big Bang hypothesis states that all the current and the past matters in the universe came into existence at the same time, at once, roughly 13.8 billion years ago. Of course, all things are made up of God or created by God, but they are made at once 13.8 billions of years ago, according to the old Earth or progressive creation theory. The third type of special creationism theory is evolutionary creationism or theistic evolution. This view of evolution believes that God had made or created things, but some active forms are left in the ongoing process through evolution. That means God had made a man once, then this man is left to reproduce. As you know, the first man is Adam, and the first woman is Eve, and these individuals are created by God, but they are left to reproduce because they have the active form. They have a reproductive system. And God had made plants once, and they are left to reproduce because they have a reproduction system. So according to this theory, things are or created by God, but they are left to reproduce and replace themselves. And the fourth type of special creationism theory is intelligent design. This theory states that life is developed or created due to the combination of natural force and the intervention of supernatural being. So life is developed or created due to the combination of natural force and the intervention of supernatural being, according to intelligent design theories of origin of life. The second types of theories of origin of life is spontaneous generation theory. This theory suggests that life can evolve spontaneously from non-living objects. For example, rotten meat is turned into flies, mud is turned, or frogs are originated from mud. However, this theory is disproved once and forever. The third one is eternity of life. The theory of eternity of life states that the universe has always existed and there has always been life in the universe. There is no beginning and no end of life on Earth, so life is neither created nor generated from non-living matter. So according to the eternity of life, there is no origin and no end of life on this universe. the fourth types of theories of origin of life is cosmozoan theories of origin of life. This theory states that life on Earth originally came from elsewhere, especially from other planets in the universe. For example, meteorites brought bacterial spores and germs to the Earth. This theory didn't gain any significant support because it lacks evidence and it is strongly linked to eternities of lives of origin of life. The fifth one is biochemical theories of origin of life. This theory suggests that life on Earth originates as a result of a number of chemical reactions producing organic molecules which combines or associated to form cell or first life. This theory is also known as abiogenesis, that states that life originates from chemical inanimate, that means abiotic substance. According to biochemical theories of origin of life, life originates from different chemical reactions of molecules than life is originated.
Thank you once again, and I will come back soon with another new video. See you.